you for the introduction. So as it was said, I'm working in the Open and Experimental Center for EV Oil in collaboration with Total. And we are trying to improve recovery method to produce EV oil reservoir existing in the world. So for that, we use partly COMSOL for modeling. So why we are interested in EV oil? As you should know, conventional resources in petroleum activity will last for maybe 40 years. And if you want to extend our capability to produce oil, then you have to look on another kind of resources, which is the EV oil. Currently, this resources is really interesting because she have huge potential. For example, as you can see in this map, world map, you can see that in the American continent, there is almost twice the volume of conventional oil that exists in Saudi Arabia's reserves, which is the greatest volume of conventional oil. But the big challenge is that today there is only 3% of this kind of reserves that are produced, and you need to find techniques to produce this reserve. So in our works, we are interested in the most difficult kind of oil of this family, which is the oil sands and bitumen, which are really difficult to produce because due to the really high viscosity and API, they are considered as non-mobile, and then it's not possible to produce with classical techniques. So in the industrial application, there exists some technique to produce inside the 3% that are currently applied. This technique, this family, we have a classical technique, which is the cold production, which consists to inject inside the geology some diluents in order to produce the oil. But it's only for oil which have a low mobility. If you don't have mobility, it's impossible to produce your reserve like this. So it's only for a few parts of EV oil reserve. So for the other part, in which the oil is considered as non-mobile, we have two possibilities currently. Depending on the depth of the reserves, you can apply an open mine, open pipe mining, which consists to directly take the oil from the ground. And another one, if the reservoir is too deep inside the ground, is to apply thermal recovery method. Here it's the main one which is used in Canada, for example, which is steam-assisted gravity drainage, which consists to inject some steam inside the reservoir at high pressure and high temperature to allow mobility and then production. So in our study, we are interested in really deep reserve with non-mobile oil, in which this kind of technology, such open pipe mining and SAGD method, are not allowed, which is maybe 80% of the case. So why we are using thermal recovery method? As you know, for fluid, if you increase the temperature, you will decrease the viscosity. And it's exactly what happened for the oil sands and bitumen. If you significantly increase the temperature of the oil, you will create mobility inside the geology, and then you will be able to use conventional recovery techniques. That's why it's really interesting to use this kind of technology for petroleum company. Unfortunately, such technology is really difficult to apply because it's as complex as costly, obviously. And the energy efficiency becomes the key point of our study. So here I present a technology we are studying at Chloé. It's based on the electromagnetic heating. We have some device place inside the geology, which is linked to a generator at the surface to transmit electromagnetic wave inside the reservoir, and then create some vaporization. This vaporization of the water is really important because compared to other techniques, we don't have to inject water or steam. We only use what exists inside the reservoir. Another benefit is you can heat deeper because the electromagnetic wave is not sensitive to the gas, to the steam, so we can go further in the reservoir compared to other classical methods such as conductive electrical heating that exist. The advantage compared to the SAGD currently used in Canada is that we are able to work at a really low reservoir pressure because you don't have to, compared to SAGD, SAGD needs to have high pressure in order to extend quickly the steam chamber. But here it's not necessary because it's the wave propagation that creates this steam chamber. But vaporization, as you know, depends strongly on the working pressure. So in some case, it's not always possible to apply this technology because the reservoir pressure is too high, and so the vaporization temperature is also high, and then it requires too much energy to reach that point. So this technology, to summary, have some advantage and inconvenience. The most advantage, as I said, is that compared to existing technology as SAGD, you remove the heat loss due to the transport from the steam generated to the surface inside the geology, and also the injectivity problem due to this injection of steam inside the geology. An advantage, as I said, is that we create directly the heat source inside the geology using what exists in the geology without adding something, but you can if you want. It's interesting to see that it reduces the environmental impact because the installation in surface are easier to realize, and compared to mining, for example, the impact is really lower. The inconvenient is that the technology have also energy loss in the transmission line, which is often made by coaxial cable. But we know that using some specific material, we can reduce this loss. But due to this complex technology, it is still important to improve the efficiency of the heating and the economics behind, because this kind of antenna, for example, for this technology, is still not mature and does not exist in commercial activity. So everything has to be developed. But to evaluate this technology before doing to commercial application, we need to have a powerful simulator in order to test this technique. So we have a multi-physics problem, which is composed of multi-phase flow in porous media. We have phase transition, heat transfer, electromagnetic field, but we also have chemical reaction, thermodynamic equilibrium. There is a lot of things. So how we can solve this complex problem with a simulator? The first idea, born at Chloé 7 years ago, was to use only COMSOL to model everything. So my predecessor shows that it was really accurate. It takes into account almost all the physics. The interface was easy to handle, but for a reservoir scale, which is really, really big, the finite element inside COMSOL multiphysics is really time consuming. And from an industrial point of view, from petroleum industry, it is not a reservoir simulator, so that's why they're not in good agreement with fully used COMSOL for this application. So they said, okay, maybe we can use a reservoir simulator somewhere that is able to do this. Even if there is more than 15 years of research that is efficient at reservoir scale, they take into account all the physics for complex fluid composition. No software, no reservoir simulator exists in the world that are able to model electromagnetic field at high frequency. There is the case for low frequency, but not for high frequency heating. So our idea 4 years ago said that maybe we can put together the two software and then create an interface that will allow communication and coupling between the two software. This interface is called EMIR for electromagnetism interacting with reservoir. This approach is really interesting because we take advantage of both software, and the inconvenient of one is compensated by the advantage of the other one. So the foundation behind the coupling is illustrated here. The only need that the reservoir simulator have is to give him the information about the heating energy dissipated in each reservoir grid block at each coupling time steps. It will apply this energy from one time to another one, and you will have to give him another time the heating energy. So assuming that our propagation is time harmonic, it's really easy to split our problem in two parts and then solve it easily. The only restriction is we have to give him a global quantity about the heating energy in each grid block. So as you can see, if you have to compute the integral, the integral of the energy, if you have in blue some grid mesh in COMSOL compared to the reservoir grid, so you want to estimate in this grid the electromagnetic energy, you can say that to compute the integral in COMSOL in this blue mesh, it's difficult to say which contribution came in which block. But if you do some assumption on the meshing method in COMSOL, then the natural the computation is natural. So the algorithm can be summarized like this. You have a simulation over time, a reservoir simulation, and then you define at some specific time, you will give him the information about the new heating map inside the reservoir, and then continue. At each time step, then you look at the in-situ information on saturation, pressure, temperature, composition, and everything you can have to estimate in our interface using some own mixing law, the permittivity, permeability, and conductivity in each mesh element of COMSOL, and then ask COMSOL to compute the electromagnetic solution, and then EMIR retrieves the heating power and sends this information to the reservoir simulator. Using this principle, the simulation could be done easily. So I want to illustrate on a basic example. We have a cubic reservoir here, which is homogeneous, in which we place in the middle a simple dipole antenna, in which we have a power supply on the upper part, and we have an electromagnetic window placed here that will allow radiation inside the geology. As you can see here, I illustrate that you can have complex geometry meshing method for the antenna, but you always have to respect the reservoir grid description if you are inside the reservoir. So with COMSOL, it was really interesting because the antenna design is really easy to create, and the finite element is really adapted to model the electromagnetic field compared to reservoir simulator, in which, due to the numerical method, it's not possible to do something like this. The matching between both simulators is ensured with the Java API of COMSOL in order to get all the information of the COMSOL model and ensure communication with the reservoir simulator. Unfortunately, because both software don't use the same numerical methods, we can model the internal heating propagation inside due to the existence of the antenna inside the reservoir. The reservoir never see this heating part. So to have an idea of the computational time of such technique in this really small pattern, we try to produce over a period of 4 years using an input power of 120 kilowatts. And we create 1,000 coupling time steps, which represents 1.5 a day. And then for each coupling time step, for example, COMSOL take only 4 minutes. It can seem that it's not really important, but 4 minutes for each one represent a big difficulty on a longer period. So as you can see here, a global simulation for a small sample of reservoir took few days, 4-6 days. And the contribution in the computational time for both reservoir simulator and COMSOL is almost the same. And so our effort to improve our modeling and our computational performance are really important in both software too. That's why we are following the evolution of COMSOL and try to take advantage of new features as much as possible. So here is an example of what we can do now in petroleum industry, in our partner with Total. We are able to model the effect of electromagnetic heating inside a reservoir composed with oil sands and bitumen. So here we can see that now we are able to follow the evolution of the temperature, the triphasic displacement, triphasic evolution, the desaturation zone due to the production, and even where the heating occurs. So this is really interesting because it's the first time that petroleum companies are able to model such technology. So to conclude my presentation, I would just say that due to our works, we create an interface between two software, which is really interesting for petroleum industry and allows them to evaluate technology on a really difficult situation and maybe extend the productivity of their fields. Using COMSOL, it's really interesting because COMSOL throws its Java API, it's like for MATLAB, but its Java API is really powerful to coup together simulators which are programming in different language or with different data sets. So it's really, really interesting to use the Java API. And so even now, if needed, we know that we can add dedicated petroleum software in addition of this one to model geomechanical structure or other property. And so in future works, we're interested to improve our computation time to test some distributed memory solver on cluster. And from a modeling point of view, what we try to do now is to add between the generator in the surface and the antenna, we want to add an antenna tuner in order to improve the energy efficiency propagation in the reservoir. And for that, we will put together the RF module of COMSOL with the AC-DC1 in order to model this device. And finally, because we have a really big domain, we will use a new feature available since the version 5 of COMSOL, which is the conditional if and if feature in order to optimize the computational domain a long time. So we will have something like dynamic grid along the simulation time. So I finish. So thank you for your attention. Okay.